Why should you think that I should go into school? Look, when I vow, I weep, and vows so born in their nativity, all truth appears. How can these things in me seem scorned to you, bearing the badge of faith to prove them true?
You do advance your claim more and more, when truth kills truth. Oh, devilish holy trade, these vows are hernias, would you give her o'er?
I had no judgment when to her I swore.
Nor none in my mind now that you give her o'er.
Demetrius loves her, and he loves you not.
Oh, Helena, goddess, nymph, perfect divine, to what, my love, shall I compare thine eye? Oh, write and show thy lips, those kissing cherries, tempting grove. Oh, to kiss this princess of pure white, this seal of bliss.
Oh, spite, oh, hell! I see you are all pent and joined against me for your merriment. If you were civil in your courtesy, you would not do me thus much injury. Can you not hate me, as I know you do, but you must join in souls to mock me too? If you were men, as men you are in show, you would not use a gentle lady so, to vow and swear and super praise my parts, when I know you hate me with your hearts. You both are rivals in love Hermia, not both rivals to mock Helena. A trim exploit, a manly enterprise to conjure tears of your poor maid's eyes with your derision. Not a noble sark would so offend a virgin and distort a poor soul's patience, ultimately sport.
You are unkind, Demetrius, be not so, for you love Hermia, this you know I know. And with all goodwill, with all my heart, Hermia's love, I yield to my heart, and yours of Helena to me bequeath, whom I love and will to death.
Never did mockers raise mark of breath.
Lysander, keep thy Hermia, I will none. If ever I love her, all that love is gone. My heart to her, but guess why so yearns, and to Helena is home returned. There to remain.
Helen, it is not so.
Despair is not the fate thou dost not know, lest to thy peril thou buy it dear. Look where thy love comes, yonder is thy dear.
Dark night, that by the eye dysfunction takes, the ear more quick of apprehension makes. Thou art not by my eye, Lysander, found. My ear, I think, it brought me to thy sound. But why unkindly dost thou leave me so?
Why should he stay whom love doth press to go?
What love could press Lysander from my side?
Lysander's love, which would not let him abide fair Helena, who more in gilds the night than all yon fiery bows and eyes of light. Why seekest thou me? Could not this make thee know that hate I bear thee made me weep thee so?
You speak not as you think. It cannot be.
Lo, she is one of this confederacy. Now I perceive they have conjoined all three to fashion this false word in spite of me. Injurious Hermia, most ungrateful maid, have you with these contrived to bait thee with this foul derision? Oh, is all the counsel which you have shared to the sister's vow now is fit? Oh, is all forgot? And will you rend our ancient love asunder to join with men and sworn to your poor friend? It is not friendly, tis not maidenly. Our sex as well as I am tragic for it, though do alone for the injury.
I am amazed at your passionate words. I scorn you not, it seems you scorn me.
Have you not said Lysander as you scorned to play in my eyes and face?
And made your other love Demetrius, the
only goddess nymph divine and rare? Precious, celestial, what for speaks he thus to her he hates? You wherefore called Lysander that now your love, so rigid in his soul, and tender means forsooth affection but by your setting on, by your consent.
I understand not what you mean by this.
I do, for sir, counterfeit sad looks, make mouths upon me when I turn my pack, wink at each other, hold this sweet jest up. This sport well counted shall be chronicled. If you have any pity, grace, and manners, you would not make me such an argument. But fare ye well, tis part of my fault, which death or absence shall soon remain.
Stay, Helena, hear my excuse, my life, my love, fair Helen.
Oh, excellent.
Sweet, do not scorn her so.
If she cannot entreat, I can compel.
Thou canst compel no more than she can entreat. Thy threats have no more strength than her weak prayers. Helen, I tell thee, by my life I do. I swear to you by that which I will lose for thee to prove him false, that says I love thee not.
I say I love thee more than he can do.
If thou say so, withdraw and prove it.
Quick, come!
Sander, where two tents are?
Hang off, thou cat! Thou burr, vile thing, let loose! I will shake thee from me like a serpent.
Why are you grown so rude? What changes this sweet love?
Thy love, out, loathed medicine, out, hated potion, hits.
Do you not check?
Yes, sooth, and so do you.
Demetrius, I will keep my word with thee.
I would I had your bond. for I perceive a weak bond holds you. I'll not trust your word.
What, should I hurt her, strike her, kill her dead? Although I hate her, I'll not harm her so.
What? Can you do me greater harm than hate? Hate me? Wherefore, oh me, what news, my love? Am I not Hermia? Are you not Lysander? I am as fair now as I was erewhile. Since night you loved me, yet since night you left me. Why you left me? God forbid. In earnest, shall I say?
Aye, by my life. Never the desire to see thee more, therefore be out of hope, of question, of doubt. 'Tis nothing truer that I do hate thee and love Helena.
Oh me, you juggler, you canker blossom, you thief of love, what have you come by night and stole my love's heart from him?
Oh, nymph, have you no modesty, no maiden shame, no touch of bashfulness? What, will you tear patient answers from my gentle tongue? Bye-bye, you counterfeit you, puppet you.
Puppet? Why so? Aye, that way goes the game. Now I perceive that she hath been compared between our statures. She hath urged her height, and with her personage, her tall personage, her height, forsooth, she hath prevailed with him. And are you from Rome so high in his esteem as I am so dwarfish?
I'm afraid Helena shall not harm thee.
No, sir, she shall not, though you take her part.
Oh, when she is angry, she's keen and true. She was a vixen when she went to school, and though she be but little, she's fierce. Little? Again, nothing but low and little. Why will you allow her to spot me thus? Let me come to her!
Get you gone, you dwarf! You minimus of hindering that press hate! You bee! You acorn!
You are too officious in her behalf than scorned your services. Let her alone. Speak not of Helena. Take not her part.
Now she holds me not. Now follow if thou darest to try who's right. Thine and mine is host in Helena.
Follow? Nay, I'll go with thee, cheek by jowl.
You miss